Yeah. Nice. Or at least posing for a picture.
Microphone. Can everyone hear the guitar? Kevin, hear the guitar? Stephen has been kind enough to let me introduce the band. And, you know, I want to thank everybody first for being here. Second, obviously thanking my lovely wife, Jen, for accommodating my total absorption of geekdom into the Guided by Voices and providing, working so hard to help create these beautiful grounds that we're enjoying this afternoon on. And thank you so much, Jen. I love you. And the next thing I want to thank is someone who isn't here. I want to thank Bob Pollard and the band Guided by Voices, not just for the beautiful music that we've all enjoyed for so long, but I want to thank Bob for fostering this community, because this wouldn't exist without Bob's blessing of putting these parties together in Heat Fest for all of these years. None of this would exist without his blessing and approval. So thank you, Bob, for that. And that got me thinking about the whole weekend and how there's people here from Australia and LA and all over the world, and people I've known from high school who are my closest friends in my entire life, John Tobbs, and people who I'm just meeting today for the first time, and we've been friends on Facebook. So I think that is so cool. I'm so thankful these guys have put in the work. This is going to be great. And so what I was thinking was, we have this beautiful weekend together like we do every year, and we all barely know each other, except we get together at the shows and we see each other and we hug and we're happy to be each other with each other every year. And how well do we really know each other outside of it and all of those things? But when I go to these, and then we'll go back to work and to our lives and our families after the weekend. And the people that you know, they don't even know who Guided by Voices are, right? And they, not only do they not know, they think it's weird that you're an adult who's chasing a band around that they've never even freaking heard of anyway. So who the hell is that? So it's not even like, you know, it's the Stones or something, you know, it's some no-name band from Nowheresville, you know, America, right?
Hey.
And how weird is that, right? But when I'm at these events, I don't see a bunch. I see a bunch of disparate strangers all together. And we're all here together, and we know each other, and we don't know each other as well. But I also see like a mirror of my own, you know. We're all the same way. We're all sharing this freaking geekdom, or we wouldn't be here, or we're connected to someone who is. We wouldn't be here today if we weren't doing that together. So it's so validating to share the space with a bunch of people who say, you know what? What you're doing is fucking awesome. And you're an awesome fucking person for doing it, and I'm here doing it too. So, Steven, I love you all. Enjoy the teenage FBI.
Thank you, Matthew. What a beautiful crowd. Dude, this is the most beautiful crowd could ask for. Good afternoon, beautiful people. We are Teenage FBI. For obvious reasons, we are composed of two teenagers and a teenager at heart. We formed, you know, we're celebrating 40 years of GBV. We are selling 40 days as a band. We formed about 40 days ago. We may have played, what, three, four times as a complete band? You know, some one-off stuff. So we're gonna screw some shit up today. We don't know all the chords. I definitely don't know all the lyrics. But we're here to celebrate, as Matthew said, 40 years of the greatest band that God put on this planet. Voices! Yeah. Let's hear it! GBV! 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 Thank you, Robert Pollard, as Matthew said, for 40 years of the best songs ever written. We come to you from the small town of Gibbsboro, New Jersey, which I proclaim in front of you on this day to be the sister town of Dayton, Ohio. My sister, she's got the Dinosaur Jr. shirt, who's also the mother of our drummer, is on the town council. So Chris, get back to Gibbsboro and make that happen. All right, as I said, we're rusty. We're not ready to play, but we're doing it. Because we love the songs, we love Bob, we love all of you. It's a community. Where's Ian? Ian's wearing a shirt that says community. We are a community. Come on out of here. I saw it. This is a community. Community. All of us, just like Matthew said. And we are not here to perform for you. We are here to perform with you. This is Prague Rock parking lot on steroids. This is a sing-along. I know you guys know the words of these songs. So do not hold back. Without further ado, we'll bust into our first one.
Razorbug.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you, thank you, thank you. You are the best.
You guys sound awesome.
You sound awesome.
Steve.
Yes, sir.
You're one third of the way to getting the hair right. So
the drummer, who invited this guy?
The drummer's gonna shave his head, right?
He's gotta take his shirt off here soon.
Oh yeah, okay.
Get real dangerous.
Oh, he gave me a bad look.
Alright, we're celebrating 40 years of GBB. This one is off the masterpiece, B-1000. And when I first got into GBB, I bought this album. And this is one of the songs, one of the first songs that stuck out to me. Track to Rape Chain.
Yep.
And they would play it, like, I'd go see them live, like, in the late 90s. And they'd play it in the middle of their set. I'd be like, why are they playing their very best song in the middle of the set? Because I wasn't familiar with Game of Pricks, Salty Salute, you know, Cut Out Witch, all those classics. So to me, for a short period, I thought, man, this is their best song. So we're gonna play it for you. It's called Track to Rape Chain. We're missing Julie. Is Julie here? Julie Burnell?
No.
He's going to dedicate this next one to her. You guys check out that SheBV. Any SheBV? That SheBV video of Big Boring Wedding. It's fantastic. If you get a chance, check it out. It's on YouTube. Big Boring Wedding, SheBV. And we're going to play it for you. If I can remember the notes. Thank you. pleasure. I introduce myself to call and thank you for such delicious lunch. Is called, what's it called, Jackson?
Chopping broccoli.
I'm chopping broccoli. Why did you end? as I mentioned early on, this is not us performing. This is a community event. So we would like to bring up a special guest, Mr. Matt Bartsch.
Yeah!
Because we knew we couldn't perform without having a Matt perform with us. Chucky!
He was the first one to say yes.
This song is how we got our name, Teenage FBI.
Jesus.
Oh. This song is for a very good friend of mine, David Mitchell. This song is for you.
Yeah.
We want to mix it up a little bit. We're gonna do some trivia. You got your cards out. Get your cards out.
Y'all take off.
Who was the youngest musician to have ever played Heat Fest? Owen. He was 8 or 9, and the textbook committee, greatest tribute band there is, gave him the opportunity to play. Came back a few years later, played again. And this is the song he played.
Thank you.
got to do Shocker and Gloom Town.
Oh, yes.
All
right.
Were you there? Were you kicking alive and out? Hey, Julie was going to do it. Julie's not here. Brian, you're up.
Yeah, but do I remember the word, all the words?
This is Child's Play. Yeah. Darren, were you kicking? Yeah. Alive and I owe something. Well,
I'm just going to blur it.
All right, here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4.
We're going to start that one over. We're going to start it over.
That sounds like a Minuteman song, man.
Were you there? Were you kicking? If you're gonna, if you're gonna fuck up a song, that's the way to do it. Right
there. You were fucking it up last night, man. You heard that shit. Do you think Bob is annoyed when that happens? Do you think?
Nah, he doesn't.
Nah.
Are you sure?
I've seen a show where he played the same song twice.
I don't think he remembers. He fucked it up.
We're going to go to, we're celebrating 40 years of GBB, right? 40 fucking years, GBB!
That's a lot of years, man.
It's a lot of years. This one is from 2023.
That's this year.
You get a gold star for Matthew. It's called Romeo Surgeon. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much. You guys are the best crowd we've ever played for.
Yeah. That was good.
You guys can come to Dayton anytime.
My good friend, Chuck Papp, is here. Now, you guys know this. Within the GBV community, you have to have a best friend. It's a buddy system, is it not, Matt? Who's your best friend? Come here.
There they are.
Look at these guys. Best friends. Kevin, who's your best friend?
Yeah.
Best Kevin and Ian. Jackson, who's your best friend? Owen, okay. Chuck Papp is my best GBV friend. We've been through a lot together, a lot of shows. I've seen his band play. He's been gracious enough to let me sing and screw up songs with him as well. So if you do not have a GBV best friend, come see me after the set and I will assign one to you. Chuck, is everyone familiar with Omega Music?
Yeah!
Yeah, record store here in Dayton, right? Omega Music.
Come see
Chuck!
Not this week.
Chuck is an Omega. And who owns Omega Music?
Alex.
Alex and the Omegas.
That's right.
So this song has two significance to us. One is my good friend Chuck. I love you all. But it also has another significance. Jackson's girlfriend's name is Alex. So we're dedicating this one to my good friend Chuck Papp, who is an Omega, and Jackson's girlfriend Alex.
You got a girlfriend?
Yeah, you're too young.
He's not the drummer.
It is Alex and the Omegas.
Back my soul with a broken fist. The kids are gone out where the gold is accomplished. Little Rose is gone. Mother is on a truck. Truck and the Omegas. Disciple, turn your cup, please go my life. All right.
We love you people. At this point in the juncture, we would like to invite our good friend Kevin up. I'm dedicating this one to Steven Stephanakis, and he knows why.
What are we doing? Official Iron Man.
Oh, cool. You're not going to play it?
Oh, you want me to play it? No, you play it. Come on. I forgot. You did ask me to play it.
Were you guys talking about email or texting?
No, he flew them out to LA for a week. We've had this going for a while.
Yep. Contact Kevin's agent. Tough negotiation.
Hello, hello. Oops. I haven't played guitar in a while. Uh-oh. Allison's here.
Oh,
hi.
That
sounds good. Cool. Well, thank you for having us. You guys ready? Bit of fish and crude off sea. You don't have to bother me. You just have to join in on this song. Crawling people on their knees. Don't take this so seriously. You just have to join in all day long. A signal and free us from our traps. You won't see me turn my back with my head against my step, spinning deep and breaking off the tape. Is you and you are free, jump beyond the shade.
That's the way I wish I could sing. I can't sing. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for sticking with us. This next song is our bass player Jackson's favorite song.
It's also something my grandfather would call any waitress within arm distance.
Exactly. It is 2023, man.
Am I going to get Me Too?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, Jackson is Jackson. So we need, all right, we're celebrating 40 years of Guided by Voices, 40 days of Teenage FBI. You know, Owen and I have been playing together since he was a wee little lad. We have a little band that we
jam out together with. And we're like, dude, it'd be so cool to play this thing. We need a bass player. He said, my friend Jackson plays guitar. Maybe we can get him to play bass. Jackson's like, yeah, I'll play bass, but you gotta play Fair Touching. So this one is for Jackson. Is the way to fuck up a song. That's the way to do it.
It's a great song to fuck up.
I didn't hear it. You're the best uncle on the planet.
Woo!
All right.
Yeah. Next song. Excellent choice.
Where is Jennifer LeClaire? Yeah. Could we get Jennifer LeClaire? This one is for you. Thank you. screwed it up. Maybe we were just... That was our least practice song. Thank you so much, Jennifer. Thanks again for having us. Matthew, Jennifer, you guys are the best. Him up, so we're gonna bring Chuck up. He's a better singer, better player. He's got a couple for you. Hey y'all, I'm really glad to be here. This is my buddy, my good buddy Riz. The Riz. Let's hear it for the Riz. It's also really great to be playing with my shirt off twin. Just trust me. Just trust me on that. Look inside your eyes. The other one smiles so nice. This patio is nice. Maybe the twice as old I feel. Maybe the time is like you know. Promise me not to. Looking inside your eyes, and Christ, it's a crowded night. I love you, I must confess. Yeah.
I played that one pretty badly, so I didn't want to play anymore.
This is 14 Cheerleader Colts.
There you go.
Hey, brothers, I only wanna get you high.
anybody all right, motherfuckers? Where's John Tobbs? John Tobbs, please report to the deck, please. John Tobbs, you lost your wallet. Where's JT? We need him. Bring him out. We'll get him next song. Could you have a seat, please? For you, it was not in the set list, and there was a lot of debate. Our drummer did not want to play. What the hell kind of a song is that? Speaking of our drummer, he's gonna come up and sing a song.
Wow, yeah!
40 years of GBV, friends. 40 years of the greatest band ever, GBV. GBV! Aside from Bob, probably the most significant songwriter in the band was Tobin Sprout, right? We gotta do a Sprout song here. So, this is A Good Flying Bird. The worst we've ever been. Of the greatest band ever, guided by voices, we're gonna go in the way back machine, way, way back to 1986, wow. The very first EP, Forever Since Breakfast. This is the very first song off the very first CD.
or first EP, and it's called The Land of Danger.
Oh.
Masters at fucking up. I think we've mastered how to fuck up. We just keep going, we get back on track, and we finish. That's what she said. All right, good kids, thanks for sticking with us. Jackson said, we have to have an encore. I said, listen, if we stop playing, that's it, dude. They're gone. They're not coming back. We're not GBB. I said, if GBB was the Olympic-sized swimming pool, we're the kiddie pool. So we stopped playing. So this is our encore, kids. We're just going to go right into it. We got four more songs. Thank you for staying with us. We really appreciate it. This is the encore. Four songs. Wait, you got to sing this. Brian Fellhandler, ladies and gentlemen, Brian Fellhandler. There we go. Get that mic out of there. Get that mic out. There you go. Feel free to work there.
If anybody has video of me on stage singing this with Bob in 1998, please send it to me soon. It's eluded me all these years.
Oh.
I can't sing. These motherfuckers can sing. Brian, where are you going?
Get drinks.
You guys are in the band. Can we vote on this? Brian and Chuck are in the band.
Yeah.
Finish it off, boys.
Three more songs. Just get up there. Just go.
Don't worry about it. Just go. For this one, I always
fucked them up. I fucked them up in front of Bob once.
This band does rock, and thank you, Matt and June, and everybody. Love you all. Tonight's gonna be badass. Don't forget about tomorrow.
I love you, John.
What I told the kids, because Jackson, he's an audio guy. I plug in and play. I don't care what tone it is. I just fucking play. Jackson's like, I got a pedal you can use on a pedal. Fuck the pedal. I said it's not about the tone. It's not about fucking up. It's about the songs. These songs are the best songs ever written by fucking Robert Pollard. These songs are phenomenal. The songs speak for themselves, so we're not afraid to fuck them up. Everyone stand up for this one. This is our last song. Stand up, come on. Get everybody up. This song is how we are going to spend the rest of this weekend and how we've already spent it. Smothered in hug.
Send this tape to, we're videoing this, we're going to send it to Matt Davis. We hope that this may be a you know, our entry into opening band for Heat Fest, the next Heat Fest. We didn't spend much time practicing. Oh, I forgot to introduce my band! On bass, Jackson Tulo. On the traps, Owen Karsh, perennial Heat Fester, and I myself am
Steve,
not Bob.
Steve V.
You guys done?
Fucking bees.
Yeah, man, it looks, huh?
By the thousand, yeah. By the thousand. So we're at the bar next to Terragram, and he's standing there with the banner. And I come over and I go, I'd recognize you. Don't worry, call anything.
No, but then you wax. There's a lady in the
show.
He waxes the rabbit out. You know, when you're at the glory,
I ignored her now.
Well, I was talking to my wife in the elevator, and Kevin's just the whole time in like the confines.
What time are the strippers coming over? I said small boy. And you brought the singles, right? You brought the singles.
Rookie mistake if we got five. Come on.
He's making a phone call in the elevator in front of me. What am I supposed to do? Let him have it.
Andrew's like, honestly, go see some dates.
Well, he's in the ring. We are pretty harsh about dates. And I said the last time I saw a stripper in, she had two glass eyes, but she didn't know what she was doing.
Can I get you water? Yeah, I was hoping to go
they
somewhere.
They out on stage.
You
have
a thing.
Oh, I can bring the mic. Stripper with two glass eyes. You can always count on like Kevin to like step in. We went to Columbus and it was 2021, so we're all kind of masked up, we're following and whatever. So we get in an elevator and so we go down and then the doors open another floor. Or maybe it was like right before we were about to go out. So some lady starts to step in, she sees our masks and she's like, I'll get you another elevator since you guys are so afraid. And we're just kind of like, fine. And then Kevin's like, excuse me? More like informed.
When she was, and then that's when her response goes, she got on the elevator with us. She goes, y'all must be from a blue state. They do things differently here.
Yeah, we're trying to go over
like,
her here
she
in
said,
Ohio.
Remember, this was in the pandemic.
You're in a red state now.
She was a bit.
Yeah, except.
enough of them are dying off where it's not going to be a red state.
I just can't imagine, like, somebody wearing his, like, monster structure or whatever, and we're like, you're in a blue state. Like, we're just like, hey, welcome.
The part that stung was, I didn't even think about that. My initial thought was maybe she doesn't want to get on an elevator with a bunch of dudes. So I was going to let her, you know what I mean? Yeah. My intent was nice to kind of, yeah, and she was got all, like,
Well, everyone was on edge then, and I mean, Fox News and Republicans, their whole strategy is to discourage people from participating.
They were strong.
Getting people so angry. Well, but they're strong against everything. The idea is to, if you, they can't win a majority, so you have to skew it.
Coalesce.
I had a brief window, and my father was a congressman for a long time, and I had a brief window into this strategy where you shave off and get an electorate you demand. And then that's how you win it. Not in the White House, awfully close though.
You never know if he kept rising.
He was in charge of the Appropriations Committee. So he's pretty, he's about five steps from the president.
Yeah, you can all see it, because it's like if I'm trying to get they got me nothing, and I'm like, hey, listen, Kevin, I really need you to give tax cuts to the wealthiest and to corporations. It's like, if you can kind of coalesce.
It's not nearly as good.
Yeah, I'm afraid.
Oh, well.
In there.